Welcome back. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to set up your new Google Pixel and bring old data from your old phone. For this example, we'll be transferring data from an old Samsung phone to the Google Pixel, but the method will be almost identical for whichever old device you have, especially if it's Android. If your old device is an iPhone, then there will be some slightly different steps, but you should still be able to follow along. If you don't need to bring data from an old device, you can simply skip this section when we get to it. Start unboxing your new device now if you haven't already, and feel free to use the video chapters to skip past any sections you've already done. Let's get started. There's a few things to mention before we can set up and transfer. First, it's important to talk about the SIM card. There seems to be mixed opinions on whether you should move it before or after the transfer of any data. It shouldn't affect the transfer in any way, and I've already moved the SIM over before powering on the new phone for the first time. Of course, turn off your old phone before removing the SIM card. If you have a new SIM or you don't need to bring data, you can insert it now. The transfer may bring the data off your microSD card if you have one and put it onto the internal storage of your new phone. If you don't want it to do this, you could remove the SD card for now and then insert it into your new phone after the switch, but only if it supports one. Again, make sure your devices are off if you do this. Another thing to mention is that transferring data won't delete that data on your old phone. That phone will still work as normal with your files and apps. The only difference will be that because it doesn't have a SIM, no cellular functions will work. But it will still have Wi-Fi for us to be able to transfer. Next, make sure both your phones have enough battery power to be able to complete the transfer and setup. And I'd recommend having the charging cable ready if you need to charge either device during the transfer. You may also want to use the cable to transfer the data between the two devices, however a good Wi-Fi connection should work fine. If your old phone is an Android device, you could also check that you are signed into the correct Google account on this device. You should be able to check this on the account settings page, as you'll need to make sure you use this same Google account on your new Pixel. Turn on Bluetooth on your old device now as well, as you might need this for the setup and transfer. Finally, the method may vary slightly depending on your Android or operating system version on your old device, so you could check for software updates to get to the latest version. We're now ready to power on our new Google Pixel for the first time. Power your old device back on now as well if you haven't already. Wait until the first setup page loads, and then you can change your language or change the accessibility settings by tapping on these options. For example, you may be able to change the text size or others. Tap on Get Started or Continue, and now you should be on a screen called Setup Using Another Device. Make sure you tap on the correct device option here. For example, if you're moving from an Android, choose the Android option. Using your old device to set up your new one will save a lot of time, even if you don't want or need to transfer any data. A QR code will appear on your new device, and you need to scan this with your old one. You should be able to do this by opening the camera app on your old device and holding it above the QR code. Then tap on the link that appears. You may be asked to turn on Bluetooth now if you haven't done so already. Tap on Continue to do this, and then wait for it to connect. Your new device should now connect to the Wi-Fi network of your old one, without you needing to enter any passwords, but if you are required to connect to one manually, choose yours from the list and enter the password. Next, allow the automatic setup page to continue until you are on the page called Verify That It's You. On here, you need to enter the information it requests, which should be the passcode from your old device. Enter this in the box, and then you can check or uncheck the box, depending on whether you want to use this PIN on your new device. You might now be asked to set up an unlock type on your new device, such as fingerprints. Follow the steps for this. You can skip this section if you want, but if you want to add your fingerprints now, agree to the terms, and then scan your fingerprint multiple times until it's added, and then tap on Next or Continue. The next page should be called Copy Data from Your Device. If you want to bring your data to your new phone, make sure you choose to do this. So for me, I need to tap on Next. Allow the automatic steps to complete, until you see the page where you can choose exactly which data you want to transfer. It is up to you what you select here, but you can use the checkbox next to each category to select the data type, such as photos and messages. If you want everything transferred, then leave all the boxes checked. Just make sure you don't go over the storage limit. Tap on copy when you're happy with the selected data, and then allow this to complete. It could take a while depending on how much data you are transferring, but you should be able to continue with the setup on your new device. The next page relates to Google services. You can customize this to your preference and continue when you're happy. For example, you may want to opt out of diagnostics data being sent. The next page is regarding warranty information, so you can just select the correct country to check it, and then continue through the pages. One of the pages should be called Continue Setup, which we can do now, so tap on Continue, and now you can set up things like the Google Assistant, by following the steps and reading the commands. You can choose to skip this by tapping on No Thanks, or Set Up Later. There should be a general setup screen, where you can choose the individual elements to customize. For example, you can customize the text size or set up additional features. Tap on Next or Continue and work through the remaining few pages and choose your preferred options for each. If all the data is now transferred, you should see the Copying's Done page, or you might need to wait until this is finished. Remember to keep an eye on the battery level of your devices, and if you're unsure about this, connect them to the charger. Once the transfer is complete, tap on Done, and there should now only be one or two pages left. Once you've followed the remaining setup steps and completed the overall device setup, you should be on the home screen of your new Google Pixel, and have all your data on it. This also includes things like your wallpaper. I'd now recommend checking that everything has copied over before you delete the contents of your old phone if you choose to do that in the future. Remember that data could still be transferring in the background. You can always move files and photos manually via the internet or a PC later, as the data on your old phone will not be deleted, as mentioned at the start. If you don't see all of your apps yet, don't worry, as these will probably still be installing. So check by swiping down from the top of the screen to see your notifications. Allow these to download and install, and it might take a while depending on how many apps need to be downloaded. Remember that some of the apps on your device might require sign-ins again, and some will have their own way of transferring data and backups. So check for the method for each of the apps you own if their data wasn't transferred within the app. You can now check out your new Google Pixel and continue to set up and customize the device in the Settings app. For example, you might want to set a data limit and warning, customize the display settings, or just explore the different options. That's how to set up your new Google Pixel and bring all data from your old phone. Click or tap the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you 10 easy ways to speed up your Android device. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below, and if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like, and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.